Ladies and gentlemen, it's the Lawrence Welk Show, celebrating more than 60 years on television. Now sit back and enjoy the show selected especially for public television.
Hello, I'm Mary Lou Metzger. Welcome to the Lawrence Welk Show. This program was taped in 1968 and features the Lennon sisters, Bobby and Sissy, and Joe Feeney on a show filled with a variety of music. Later on in this program, I'll visit with Kathy Lennon, and we'll hear her great stories of how it was being one of the famous Lennon sisters. And now, here's television's music man, Lawrence Welk.
Thank you so much, my good friend. Thank you very kindly. A pleasant good evening, my friends. A warm welcome to you all. Our musical children get things underway with a happy song from the fine movie, Dr. Doolittle.
Friends. All of us had the great pleasure of seeing Dr. Doolittle at a special studio showing, and all of us were delighted with the picture and the music. Here's a catchy little tune titled The Windows of Paris. It features Frank Scott at the new electric harpsichord, Myron Floren on the pancordion, and Neil Vang on guitar, and one of our musical children, Bob Ralston, at the organ. We invite you all to dance. Thank you. Please stand speed. Hoagy Carmichael has written many great songs. In most cases, Hoagy wrote only the melody. But here's a song for which he wrote both the music and the words. Our lovely champagne lady, Norma Zimmer, would like to sing it for you.
I get along without you very well. Of course I do. Except when soft rains fall and drip from leaves, then I recall the thrill of being sheltered in your arms. Of course I do. But I get along without you very well. I've forgotten you just like I should. Of course I have. Except to hear your name or someone's laugh that is the same. But I've forgotten you just like I should. What a fool am I to think my breaking heart could kid the moon. What's in store? Should I fall once more? No, it's best that I stick to my tune. Perhaps in spring, but I should never think of spring, for that would surely break my heart into.
Our 19-year-old singing star, Tanya Welk, has a way with popular songs. I think you will enjoy the way she sings the current hit, and you will notice that the boys in the band also enjoy this young lady's singing.
You're just too good to be true. Can't take my eyes off of you. You'd be like heaven to touch. I wanna hold you so much. At long last, love has arrived, and I thank God I'm alive. You're just too good to be true. Can't take my eyes off of you. Pardon the way that I stare. There's nothing else to compare. The sight of you leaves me weak. There are no words left to speak. But if you feel like I feel, please let me know that it's real. You're just too good to be true. Can't take my eyes off of you.
Trust it.
Well, you can see Tanya's making herself at home with our musical family. Bob Ralston turns his piano talent to one of the better melodies of the last couple of years. From the movie The Umbrellas of Cherbourg, Bob plays I Will Wait for You. Sisters have been very busy lately doing personal appearances and guest shots on other shows. It's a real pleasure to welcome the girls back for a visit, and here they are.
Lovely, lazy, carefree, crazy, where are the words that describe him? Easy, gentle, sentimental, there are no words that describe him. Easier by far, say I, to steal the sky from the song birds than to find the words that seem right. How do you describe a dream right? From the songbirds. seem right. How do you describe a dream right?
Song from Dr. Doolittle. Steve Smith sings, "When I Look in Your Eyes." In my estimation, this is one of the prettiest ballads written in a long, long time.
When I look in your eyes, I see the wisdom of the world in your eyes. I see the sadness of a thousand goodbyes. When I look in your eyes, and it is no surprise to see the softness of the moon in your eyes, to see the sparkle of the stars in the skies. When I look in your eyes, in your eyes, I see the deepness of the sea. I see the deepness of the love I feel you feel for me. Autumn comes, summer dies, I see the passing of the years in your eyes. And when we part, there'll be no tears, no goodbyes. I'll just look into your eyes. Those eyes so wise, so warm, so real. How I love the world. Your eyes reveal.
Believe it or not, in the movie, Rex Harrison sings this very pretty love song to a seal. Sissy and Bobby are both very fond of Latin music. Here they are dancing to an exciting rhythm of the samba.
Sissy King and Bobby Burgess.
More music with a Latin flavor. Andra Willis, who sings in several languages, gives us the Spanish and English words to the song Love Me With All Your Heart.
Program a lot of fun. Coming up, Jim Roberts will sing. Sandi and Salli perform a duet, and Myron Floren is featured with the band. And at the end of this program, I'll visit with one of the Lennon sisters, Kathy Lennon. And now, back to the show.
Next, we have an Irish tenor, a Scottish piano player, and some English words to an Italian song. Here's Joe Feeney with Frank Scott at the piano, the song There's No Tomorrow.
Oh, sole mio, stand fronte a te, stand fronte a te. Love is a flower that blooms so tender, each kiss a dewdrop of sweet surrender. Love is a moment of life enchanting. Let's take that moment that tonight is granting.
To sing that high note there, that strong one. Joe Feeney from Grand Island, Nebraska, Frank Scott from Fargo, North Dakota. They work so well together. All Andre Willis and Dick Dale want on their dates is a little privacy. But when they go to the movies, it turns into a family affair.
Right this way, folks. The feature's about ready to begin.
Hey, hey, there's some seats right there.
Oh, that ballroom is so dreamy.
I'd rather see a Western any day.
Come on, Mom. The movie's ready to start.
Oh, there's Andra and Dick.
Mother dear won't let me out alone. Seems that I must have a chaperone. When we go out, no matter where we're bound, there is always somebody around.
She brings her father, her mother, her sister and her brother. Oh, I never see Andra alone. She brings her uncles and cousins. She's got them by the dozens. I never see Andra alone.
And if he phones me, says to me, sweet, where shall we meet, supposing that we eat?
She brings her father, her mother, her sister and her brother. Oh, I never see Andra alone.
I am her father.
And I'm her mother.
And I'm her little brother.
Oh, they never leave Andra alone.
I am her uncle.
I'm sister. Hey, Dick, why don't you kiss her?
Oh, I never see Andra alone. I turned the lights down, they were too bright. Oh, what a night. When I turned on the light, there was her father, her mother, her little baby brother. Oh, I never see Andra alone. Gets kind of crowded. I never see Andra alone. Say, would you mind sitting down, please?
Hey, fella, you're making too much noise.
Dick,
out!
Think I'll stay and watch this again.
Oh, this isn't the cartoon.
I'd rather see a love scene.
Will you please get me some popcorn?
Yeah, you got it, boy.
Oh,
yeah.
I tell you, the movie's with you.
Some time ago, Joanne Castler recorded the song titled Made in France. Later, words were written to this melody, and our friend Jimmy Durante helped to make it popular under the title One of Those Songs. Here is Joanne with her original recording version. Summer Samba was a big record hit recently. Words have been added, and it's still going strong under the title, So Nice. We're going to ask Sandi and Salli to sing it for you.
Someone to hold me tight, that would be very nice. Someone to love me right, that would be very nice. someone to understand each little dream in me, someone to take my hand to be a team with me. So nice, that would be so nice if someday I'd find someone who would take my hand and samba through life with me. Someone to cling to me, stay with me right or wrong. Someone to sing to me some little samba song. Someone to take my heart and give their heart to me. Someone who's ready to give love a start with me. Oh yes, that would be so nice. Should it be you and so me? To cling to me, stay with me right or wrong. Someone to sing to me some little samba song. Someone to take my heart and give their heart to me. Someone who's ready to give love a start with me. Oh yes, that would be so nice. Should it be you and me? I could see that would be
so nice. And folks, that title fits these two young ladies to a T. Here's a happy song from the Broadway production High Button Shoes. Frank Scott at the harpsichord and our rhythm section join me for Papa, Won't You Dance With Me.
Thank you so much, Myron. It's encore time for the lovely Lennon sisters. The girls are all ready and raring to go, so let's join them.
We gotta get going, where are we going, what are we gonna do? We're on our way to somewhere, the four of us and you. Well, what'll we do there, who will be there, what'll be the big surprise? There may be senoritas with dark and flashing eyes. We're on our way, pack up your pack. And if we stay, we won't come back. How can we go? We haven't got a dime. But we're going, we're gonna have a happy time. Now someone said he just came back from somewhere, a friend of mine that I don't even know. He said there's lots of fun if we can get there. If that's the case, then that's the place we want to go. Gotta get going, where are we going, what are we gonna do? We're on our way to somewhere, the four of us and you. Well, what do we do there? Who will be there? What'll be the big surprise? There may be senoritas with dark and flashing eyes.
I'll take a train.
You take a train.
I'll take a boat.
You take a boat.
I'll take a plane.
You take a plane.
Hey, let's ride a goat.
Oh, no, we don't care. We don't want to climb. But we're going, we're gonna have a happy time.
Jimmy Roberts' turn in the solo spotlight. Jimmy sings a song I think you folks will remember and enjoy.
I know that someday you'll want me to want you. Though I'm in love with somebody else, you expect me to be true and keep on loving you. Though I am feeling blue, you think I can't forget you. Until someday you want me to want you. Though I'm in love with somebody else, and though you don't want me now, I'll get along somehow, and then I won't want you. And though you don't want me now, I'll get along somehow.
Treatment you gave this song. With basketball so popular all over the nation, I think you might enjoy seeing our own team in action. Let's go to the sports arena.
Hi, and welcome to the pregame show. Tonight we're interviewing three players of the famous basketball team, the Dribblers. Let's go now to the locker room and meet those three stars, Basket Burgess.
Howdy, sports fans.
Duckett Duncan.
Hi, folks.
And Dribble Immo.
Hi, sporties.
Tell me, what would you say is the most important principle in basketball?
Well, I would say that one of the most important things in the game of basketball is getting the ball through the basket.
Yes, I'm inclined to agree.
Well, what else would you consider important?
Well, of course, you've got to have teamwork.
Yes, you need teamwork, right, fellas? Right. That's right.
When three guys pull together, it's teamwork. In foul or sunny weather, it's teamwork. What does it take to make any business climb? You find it takes teamwork every time. Nobody makes a solo, it's teamwork. One tycoon can't play polo, it's teamwork. What simple thing can bring you that winning score? The answer is teamwork, nothing more. Without teamwork, unless you got teamwork, there's no team.
Now watch this one here. There's 2 points.
Teamwork.
won a lot of ball games with this. Yeah, we won a lot of ball games.
I made 50 points with this shot once.
You gotta have teamwork. What's life without teamwork? Unless you got teamwork, there's no team.
It also helps to be 10 feet tall, too.
How about those boys? I'd like to see the Celtics or the Lakers do some of those tricks. We're so very proud of Lynn Anderson and her success in the country record field. Her new record, Promises, Promises, is close to number one in the nation. Let's hear from our wonderful little country singer the song, I've Been Everywhere, and she has.
I've been everywhere, man. I've been everywhere, man. Across the deserts bare, man. I breathe the mountain air, man. And travel, I've hit my share, man. I've been everywhere. I've been to Reno, Chicago, Fargo, Minnesota, Buffalo, Toronto, Winslow, Sarasota, Wichita, Tulsa, Ottawa, Oklahoma, Tampa, Panama, Natoma, Lapaloma, Bango, Salvador, Amador, Amarillo, Listen, Killer, Amadillo, Amarillo, I'm a killer. I've been everywhere, man. I've been everywhere, man. Cross the desert's fair, man. I breathe the mountain air, man. I travel, I've had my share, man. I've been everywhere. Boston, Charleston, Dayton, Louisiana, Washington, Houston, Kingston, Texarkana, Monterey, Purdue, Santa Fe, Tallahassee, Glen Rock, Black Rock, Little Rock, Opelousa, Tennessee, Hennessy, Chippewa, Spirit Lake, Grand Lake, Devil Lake, Great Lake, Repeat Lake. I've been everywhere, man. I've been everywhere, man. Cross the desert's fair, man. I breathe the mountain air, man. I travel, I've hit my share, man. I've been everywhere. Louisville, Nashville, Knoxville, Omaha, Baker, Shuffleville, Jacksonville, Waterloo, Costa Rica, Pittsburgh, Springfield, Bakersfield, Shreveport, Eggsack, Cadillac, on the lake, Davenport, Idaho, Jellicoe, Argentina, Diamondina, Pasadena, Catalina, see what I mean, sir? I've been everywhere, man. I've been everywhere, man. Cross the desert's fair, man. I breathe the mountain air, man. I travel, I've hit my share. Pittsburgh, Cockleburg, Rambleburg, Colorado, Elmsburg, Rexburg, Vicksburg, Eldorado, Larimore, Halfmore, Havasu, Chattanooga, Chaska, Nebraska, Alaska, Ogallala, Baraboo, Waterloo, Kalamazoo, Kansas City, Sioux City, Cedar City, Dodge City, what a pity. I've been everywhere, man. I've been everywhere, man. Cross the deserts bare, man. I breathe the mountain air, man. I travel, I've had my share, man.
I know someplace you haven't been.
I've been everywhere.
We hope you've enjoyed this edition of the Lawrence Welk Show. We all got to watch my special guest grow from a little girl into a beautiful young woman on our Saturday night dates with Lawrence Welk. She was and still is one of America's sweethearts. Please welcome Kathy Lennon.
Thank you, Mayor.
Oh, we're
nice
so glad
to be
you're here.
Thank you.
Well, this show from 1968 must bring back some memories.
Wow, it really did. And when I got a chance to look at it, just so many memories of great people and how wonderful people were. Steve Smith, what a voice, you know? I mean, it was just listening to him and then doing Where Are the Words, what my sisters and I sang, because they had done a Dr. Doolittle special, and we had just come off doing the Ed Sullivan Show. And we had learned that song for the Ed Sullivan Show, and Anthony Newley was on the show, so we got a chance to really get a feel of Dr. Doolittle, and that was very special, and then be able to do it on the show. And as Mr. Welk said, that surprised me, because I forgot when I looked back and saw the show that he said we had gone to the premiere, and then I remembered we took all our little brothers, because I said, how many tickets can you use? And we brought all our little brothers and sisters to it, so they got to see Dr. Doolittle. It was pretty special.
Now, how long after this show
Did you get your own show on ABC?
You know, I was looking at that, and it's funny because when I heard us sing Quanta Lagusta, I said, little did we know, it was, you know, got to get going, where are we going? And we were down to just doing one show a month at that time, and then ABC had asked us, when we didn't work out a schedule with Mr. Welk, ABC had asked us to do our own television show for ABC. And we did the special that following fall, and then we did our show the next year, because Jimmy Durante was our special guest on the show for ABC, and they said it worked so well. What if we have a regular show, Lennon Sisters, and Jimmy Durante's on it every week? And we did that and had a great time with him, and it allowed us to work with people like the greats, Jack Benny and Bob Hope and Sammy Davis and George Burns, and because they all loved Jimmy so much, and they came on the show as guests, and at such young ages, to be able to work with these incredible vaudevillian pros was very special.
What an amazing time.
Yeah, it was an amazing time.
Now, is it true? Did you really want to be a secretary when you were a little girl?
You know, people ask me that. I did. I always did. I'm very organized. I mean, ask my sisters. It drives them crazy. Yeah, you know. And it's like making sure you have the earrings and the shoes and what matches and what doesn't. And I always wanted to do that. Because I always felt you could get your desk clean, everything, and you could lock the door and never think about it again. In performing and entertainment, you never have that 5 o'clock, turn the lock, and everything's okay. And I did get that fulfilled by, I worked in my husband's chiropractic office for about 5 years as office manager. I loved it. I was just running the place.
A dream come true.
It was, and I locked that door and said, let's go to dinner, and I didn't have to think about what key to sing in.
Well, you've also become the Lennon family historian.
I have. I always kind of have loved background. I love that our grandmother is a ballerina from Germany, and our mom's grandmother is Mexican and was born in Los Angeles, fifth generation. And I've kept pictures through the years of everything Lennon family history. And I've run across something. I'm starting kind of a collection of old pictures and old recordings that we made, because I don't know if you knew, many, many, many years ago, you could have your own recording machine. And our great aunt, my grandmother's sister, was married to William Randolph Hearst's oldest son, George, and had these gifts they would send to us. And they sent us a record-making machine where you'd pull the black stuff off of the wax and everything, and we would record in our house. And I found some of those recordings. She always called us the miracle kids. Have the miracle kids make us a record and send it up. So that's why she sent us this machine. Well, something very special happened. As I was going through them and I wanted to make some CDs for my 11 brothers and sisters for Christmas to surprise them, I came across a record of me when I was in first grade. Our Catholic school always at Christmas time put on where you would tell this Christmas story. And it was called the Araceli. And my part was the Annunciation. And when, you know, the angel Gabriel sent from God unto a city of Galilee named Nazareth. I'm like, I can still do it from first grade. And Daddy wanted me to record that and put it on a record. Well, what I found, which gets really emotional, is me on this record doing the Araceli, the Christmas song, and Daddy behind singing Ave Maria.
Oh.
And I found this record, I went, oh my gosh, because we have a few things of Daddy singing. He was a beautiful Irish tenor. And now I have that record that we're going to be making, and I'm going to surprise, if they don't see the show, my brothers and sisters with having copies of that.
Mm-hmm. Oh, what treasure.
Oh, we have such wonderful treasures. We've been very blessed with so many people sending us pictures and stories, and so I have quite an archive in my house.
Your secretarial skills have come into good use.
It works. Yeah, it does.
Well, you and Janet have started a project that's really dear to your hearts.
This is a dream come true. When Janet and I were little, we always called each other best pals, and we were the best cowboys together, and we used to sit and sing to our favorite dolls, our rag dolls that were made for us by our grandmother Nana and our mom when Janet was just 3 and I was 6. And we loved those little dolls, took them on the road with us, with Mr. Welk, played with the dolls. And a few years ago, we decided to record a children's album, and we decided to reproduce the ragdolls, which we still have. I have them here.
The originals.
They're over 60 years old. I think they're 57 years old. Of the original dolls that were made for us by Nana and Mom.
And they're in beautiful shape.
They really are. We've loved them to death, and yet we've taken care of them. We've treasured them.
And we really felt there was a hole in the toy industry for a simpler time, for little girls to stay longer, a little longer. And we thought that there would be an option for this kind of a rag doll again. And so we have reproduced them right down to the vintage fabric. Here they are in reproductions. And I know we've talked to so many of our loyal fans before about it, and they've been so thrilled with them. So these are our rag dolls. They're just really incredible. We are so proud, and this is something Jant and I are, oh, it takes so much time up, but it's a dream come through. It is something we have planned for so long, and it's here, it's happened. And it's kind of a tribute back to Mom, a Mom and Nana's spirits, or every one of these dolls. And to see them come and happen is so beautiful, and we've had an incredible reaction to them everywhere.
Oh. And your sister Peggy was involved in doing some of the original artwork.
She did. She did the original artwork on The Best Pals, the two little girls, and she wrote a little book about how we started as little best pals and grew up singing and decided to make rag dolls. And so she was involved, and Peg is a part of that has been kind of unique and special for it at the beginning.
Oh, it has to mean so much to
you. Oh, it does. It's incredible. Yes.
Well, now, you started out with the Kathy and Janet dolls.
Right.
But you've also branched out.
We are very excited about this. We have just come to, we've been wanting to do this from the beginning. We have multicultural dolls. So we have our same rag doll, but made in the different ethnic, for the children to be able to relate to what they are, to love little rag dolls. And this is Sophia. We just love her. Kind of, my mother-in-law's name is Sophia. And this is after Mom. This is Isabel.
Oh.
And that's our mom's name and our grandmother's name. So here's our little Isabel. And the clothes are like from first grade, like Janet and my clothes. I mean, they really are. And this is Lily. We just loved Lily.
Oh.
So those are our three new dolls.
It has to be successful. There's so much love behind it.
There is. Thank you, Mary. Thank you very much.
What's next for you?
Oh, wow. We have a lot more product that is coming in, like I said, like these dolls and the pets and all. And then the Lennon sisters are continuing at the Welk Resort, performing at Christmas time, a family special Christmas time. The Gatlin brothers with ourselves. We're doing a few concert tours, and we're very active in our fan club still. It's very active. And this is, we're in our 51st year of performing. We're not even 51 years old. And here we
None
are.
None of us are.
You know, yeah, exactly. And to see these PBS specials going on and on, and I think I've said this before, what a tribute. What a tribute to, one, the man who started it, and to all the performers who, it's like being at the same school. We were all raised the same by the same
That's
Papa.
True.
And we're on time. We know our schedule. We know our songs. The professionalism that this show brought to our years of now experience has been incredible and remarkable. And I think everyone along the way, meeting, being with all the performers, brings back, just your heart is just full of all the love that started way back for us at Christmas Eve 1955.
We've all been so lucky to be together.
Haven't we?
And
haven't
thank we? You. Thank you for being with us.
Thank you, Mary. Love you.
And thank you all for joining us and for being a part of our evening. Until next time, as Lawrence always said, keep a song in your heart.
You'll always remain in my heart. Good night. Sleep tight. And pleasant dreams to you. Here's a wish. Good night.
not start a war to save a union.
You have no idea what you're signing up for here.
Dear God.
Mercy Street, coming in January, only on PBS.
Are your ducks in a row? Almost half of Americans do not have a proper estate plan. Estate plans are more than matters of money and inheritance. They can guide your future health decisions.